Hello everyone. I welcome you all to my channel. Hope you are all doing well. Today we will be talking about Abdul Rahman Ibrahim Ibn Sari. Abdul Rahman Ibn Ibrahim Asari was an African nobleman and emir, commander or governor, who was captured in the Fouta Jalan region of Guinea, West Africa and sold to slave traders in the United States in 1788. Upon discovering his noble lineage, his slave master Thomas Foster began referring to him as Prince, a title he kept until his final days. After spending 40 years in slavery, he was freed in 1828 by order of U.S. President John Quincy Adams and Secretary of State Henry Clay after the Sultan of Morocco requested his release. Abdul Rahman Ibn Ibrahim Sari was a Tirad Muslim ruler, emir, born in 1762 in the city of Timbo, now located in Guinea. His father, Al-Mami Ibrahim Sari, consolidated the Islamic Confederation of Fouta Jalan in 1776, with Timbo as its capital, where Abdul Rahman lived and studied. He was learned in the Islamic sciences and could speak at least four different African languages, in addition to Arabic and English, and in 1781, after returning from studying the renowned city of learning Timbuktu, Abd Single Kotar Rahman joined the armies of his father. At age 26, he was made an emir of one of the regiments that conquered the lands of the Bambara, and in 1788 his father made him the head of a 2,000-man army whose mission was to protect the coast and strengthen their economic interest in the region. It was during this military campaign that Abd Single Kotar Rahman was captured and enslaved. He was sold to the British, who brought him to Natchez, Mississippi, where he labored on the cotton plantation of Thomas Foster for more than 38 years before gaining his freedom. In 1784 he married Isabella, another slave of Foster's, and eventually fathered a large family, five sons and four daughters. By using his knowledge of growing cotton in Fouta Jalan, Abdul Rahman rose to a position of authority on the plantation and became the de facto foreman. This granted him the opportunity to grow his own vegetable garden and sell at the local market. During this time, he met an old acquaintance, Dr. John Cox, an Irish surgeon who had served on an English ship, and had become the first white man to reach Timbo after being abandoned by his ship and then falling ill. Cox stayed ashore for 6 months and was taken in by Abdul Rahman's family, where he was tasked to teach Abdul Rahman English. Cox appealed to Foster to sell his prince so he could return to Africa. However, Foster would not budge, since he viewed Abdul Rahman as indispensable to the Foster farm. Dr. Cox continued, until his death in 1816, to seek Ibrahim's freedom, to no avail. After Cox died, his son continued the cause to free Abdul Rahman. Abdul Rahman Ibn Ibrahim Sari was a Tirad Muslim ruler, emir, born in 1762 in the city of Timbo, now located in Guinea. His father, Al-Mami Ibrahim Sari, consolidated the Islamic Confederation of Fouta Jalan in 1776, with Timbo as its capital, where Abdul Rahman lived and studied. He was learned in the Islamic sciences and could speak at least four different African languages, in addition to Arabic and English, and in 1781, after returning from studying the renowned city of learning Timbuktu, Abd Single Kotar Rahman joined the armies of his father. At age 26, he was made an emir of one of the regiments that conquered the lands of the Bambara, and in 1788 his father made him the head of a 2,000-man army whose mission was to protect the coast and strengthen their economic interest in the region. It was during this military campaign that Abd Single Kotar Rahman was captured and enslaved. He was sold to the British, who brought him to Natchez, Mississippi, where he labored on the cotton plantation of Thomas Foster for more than 38 years before gaining his freedom. In 1794 he married Isabella, another slave of Foster's, and eventually fathered a large family, five sons and four daughters. By using his knowledge of growing cotton in Fouta Jalan, Abdul Rahman rose to a position of authority on the plantation and became the de facto foreman. This granted him the opportunity to grow his own vegetable garden and sell at the local market. During this time, he met an old acquaintance, Dr. John Cox, an Irish surgeon who had served on an English ship, and had become the first white man to reach Timbo after being abandoned by his ship and then falling ill. Cox stayed ashore for 6 months and was taken in by Abdul Rahman's family, where he was tasked to teach Abdul Rahman English. Cox appealed to Foster to sell his prince so he could return to Africa. However, Foster would not budge, since he viewed Abdul Rahman as indispensable to the Foster farm. Dr. Cox continued, until his death in 1816, to seek Ibrahim's freedom, to no avail. After Cox died, his son continued the cause to free Abdul Rahman. In 1826, Abdul Rahman wrote a letter to his relatives in Africa. A local newspaper man, Andrew Marshak, who was Dutch, sent a letter to United States Senator Thomas Reed from Mississippi, who was in town at the time, and Reed forwarded it to the U.S. consulate in Morocco. Since Abdul Rahman wrote in Arabic, Marshak and the U.S. government assumed that he was a Moor. After the Sultan of Morocco Abdurrahman read the letter, he asked President Adams and Secretary of State Henry Clay to release Abdul Rahman. In 1829, Thomas Foster agreed to the release of Abdul Rahman, without payment, with the stipulation that he return to Africa and not live as a free man in America. Before leaving the U.S., Abdul Rahman and his wife went to various states in Washington, D.C. where he met with President Adams in person. He solicited donations, through the press, personal appearances, the American Colonization Society and politicians, to free his family back in Mississippi. Word got back to Foster, who considered this a breach of the agreement. Abdul Rahman's actions in freedom were also used against President John Quincy Adams by future President Andrew Jackson during the presidential election. After 10 months, Abdul Rahman and Isabella had raised only half the funds to free their children, and instead left for Monrovia, Liberia, without their children. He lived for 4 months before contracting a fever and died at the age of 67. He never saw Fouad Jallon or his children again. The funds that Abdul Rahman and Isabella raised only bought the freedom of two sons and their families. They were reunited with Isabella in Monrovia. Thomas Foster died the same year as Abdul Rahman. Foster's estate, including Abdul Rahman's other children and grandchildren, was divided among Foster's heirs and scattered across Mississippi and the South. Abdul Rahman's descendants still reside in Monrovia and in Natchez, Mississippi, United States. In 2006, Abdul Rahman's descendants gathered for a family reunion at Foster's Field. Legacy Abdul Rahman, Prince Sari, wrote two autobiographies. A drawing of him is displayed in the Library of Congress, a roadmap which one can say was left for his descendants to follow as they reconnect to the royal lineages. Prince Sori's legacy stretches from Natchez, Mississippi to Monrovia, Liberia, and with the advancements of deoxyribonucleic acid (DNA), his descendants have been able to connect with each other, such as his great-grandchildren 6 generations, Dr. Artemis Gay of Monrovia and Karen Chapman of Natchez, Mississippi. In 1968, James Register, who had been born in Natchez, wrote the first full account of Abdul Rahman's life in his book Jallon, Arabic Prince of Old Natchez, 1788-1828. In 1977, history professor Terry Alford further documented the life of Abdul Rahman in his book Prince Among Slaves. If you enjoyed this video, kindly subscribe to my channel and don't forget to leave your comments.